Hello everybody, Troy Bork here again, just showing you how I edit the Rock Band videos for Say a Pimp, where I have the gameplay capture, a real life camera, and a bass pedal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First thing I do is I import those, I drop the camera into a new composition, and then I take the gameplay and drop that into that. Now then, I will grab this little thing that looks like a guitar pick and drag it over to the right, fast forwarding. And I'm going to find where the first bass pedal hit is, right there, using PageDown to go frame by frame. I have a little bit of a cold, so if I cough or sound, my voice sounds really weird, I'm sorry. And double clicking does not help. There we go. Now then, grab the bass pedal, put it right there also. Turn that off real quick. I gotta zoom in more, sorry, it's going way too fast for me. Okay, there we go. Time, enable time remapping. Click that. The reason I'm doing that is because my bass pedal is 30 frames per second, but my camera is 29.97, and same with my that. So you can use that if your frame rates are different to resynchronize your videos. So go to where the last bass pedal is. Click on that. Go. This one's only like one frame off sync because it's such a short video. It didn't really have much time to get off sync. But the larger, 6-minute videos get really off sync. Like almost, I've seen sometimes they almost get like almost a second off synchronization, which looks really annoying. Now then, since the bass pedal synced to that, it actually is slightly ahead of where it would normally be. So I'm going to find a spot where you see both a bass pedal hit and a drum pad hit, which right up there at that thing there. As you'll notice, where it triggers there, if I actually back up, you'll see that he actually hits right there, 3 frames backwards. So I will then turn the bass pedal back on and move that. So now they are more synchronized. So like if you look at the foot, it looks more synchronized. Okay, now then, now they got all the hardest part out of the way. Let's do the gameplay. I click on the pen tool here, and then I pretty much will zoom in using scrolling the mouse wheel up, and I will click there, up there, over there, and down there, and move over. If you hold down the space bar, you can grab stuff with the hand tool. Now then, using that arrow, I'm going to be able to adjust those more evenly. My voice is starting to crap out, so sorry about this. Hit F for feather, 5-pixel feather. Take the layer, hit enter, rename it as fret, duplicate it with Control D, rename it as score, hit M, delete that mask. Collapse that one real quick. Now then go near the end so I can figure out what it looks like with all the stars there. Click on the box tool and create a box around it. Click on the arrow again, double click on that so I can drag that up. Drag that over. Drag that down. And drag that over. Now then hitting MM, I can do a 10 feather, 5 pixel expansion with a S size increase of 150 pixels. Drop it down the corner, and then take the fret, bring position, bring it down by 10 frames, and slide it over. But now that is behind that, so I got to go to this frame, video, hit position, and move that over to the right. But now we got this black box. So if we go over here to effects and type in motion and get motion tile, we can mirror the edges by 125%, so now you get that. But since the bass pedal, click on the square again, just crop that feather by 40 pixels and size by 70. I click on that and drag that up into place. Looks like I grabbed a little too much, so let's bring that in a little bit. And let's zoom in again and take this bottom one and get that so they kind of blend well together. So that way it looks like the fretboard is coming out from underneath the bass pedal. And there it is, it's pretty much most of the way done. Now then, to make it look pretty, I will grab this comp and drag it down here into a new comp. Go back to this one, take the score, Control C, copy it. Go to this one, Control V, paste it. Bring out the mask, delete the mask, transform fit to comp height, and create a new black solid. Drop that down behind this. So now you have the full plate that full of that. And then let's import recent footage, my intro logo. Drop that above that and transform fit the comp height that so it fits. Turn off the sound from that way to you don't get all those sounds mixed together, so we only get the gameplay audio. I will now go to 3 seconds and 10 frames. And then I shall turn that off so I can see. Now I take all these and drag them over to the left, fast forwarding the video. Whoa, too far. Now zoom in, and I will line this up to right where it changes camera angles. Right there. But since I have that intro logo thing, I gotta click on this, go back 10 frames, and take the audio volume and bring it down all the way. So that way it is muted, and then it fades in the audio. Now then, make that come up. Now then, those two, T for transparency, create a keyframe, easy ease it with F9. Go forward more to where that animation starts. Bring that down to zero. Now go back to this composition to get create. Now then, let's go forwards a bit until that animation stops right there, create some keyframes. Go back to where the animation was, which was right there, which is still lined up with those there. And I will transform and fit to comp height those, so now they will move over into place. Just like they normally do. Okay, let's make that one so it looks a little different. Let's ease in that one. Same thing with the fretboard or bass pedal, let's position that and move that up so it comes down into place. Make it start easy but then end hard. That sounds kind of disturbing. Let's turn on motion blur and motion blur for the composition, so now they blur when they're moving over. Now then, let's go near the end now. Same thing, create some more keyframes. Go about, to about there, I guess. Transform, fit to comp, height that. Same thing, make this animation slightly different, ease in. Position for that thing, go to the end, make it fall down. Ease in, still, don't slow down. Now I go back to this thing, create more keyframes for the opacity. Go forwards until the explosion starts. Don't hit the end key by accident. Now then, 100%. And there we go. Now the thing faded back out. Now that once the score appears, I usually do that thing to make it so it fits the whole composition. I go to this and create a position and scale. Create some keyframes, easy ease those. And I'll just go forwards a bit. Let's go to about, 245. Do a 150% increase and move it down. Go forwards 15 more frames and press N to end the composition. Trim to work area to comp. Now then, let's rename that this as Love Man as the name of the song. I will take that and drop that into a final composition, and I will edit the composition settings so they are an NTSC D1 widescreen square pixel, in other words a 16:9 ratio instead of a 3:2, so when YouTube does it right, Now that one's transformed to comp that, so it extends. And now I can save my project. I've already did this before, so I'll just save it as Untitled Project 2. And I can go to Composition, Make Movie, change my output to my XVID PCM custom preset. Pretty much all that is just a single pass, 2500 kilobits per second with 44.1 audio. And like I said, I've rendered that out, so it's called Lubman 2. Save and render. And there we go, that's it. Now, depending on the speed of your computer, this will take any amount of time. On my PC, I have an Intel Core 2 Duo, so it takes me about, you know, because I'm screen capturing now, about 14 minutes, but normally this would take about 10 minutes. Well, goodbye.